Hello guys, welcome back to Insightsias. March 22nd, 2019 turned out to be a very historic and significant day for India. In response to a call given by Prime Minister Modi to the nation in his address, people came out of their houses clapping and beating utensils. This was people's way of thanking corona fighters for keeping them safe and secure. Corona fighters here are all those people who are helping us to keep ourselves safe and secure from the spread of this disease. These include doctors, policemen, nurses, ASHA workers, army personnel, and so on. So let us all take a moment to sincerely thank all these corona fighters for keeping us and our families safe and secure. Thank you, corona fighters. And during his speech, Prime Minister Modi said that this may be a very long battle against COVID-19 and more measures are needed to contain and isolate its spread. And that is why he called for a Janta curfew on March 22nd, which was Sunday. During this period of time, people had to stay back at their homes and create social distance. And this long battle can only be won if people stay back at home and observe social distancing. And following this, many states are announcing complete lockdowns, Section 144 being imposed and curfew being imposed. All this, they say, is necessary to keep people safe and secure. But why do you think such kind of stringent and strict measures are necessary? Well, this becomes very much necessary as India has already reached the second stage of coronavirus spread. So in today's discussion, let us study the four different stages of a pandemic. Well, as per the ICMR and Union Health Ministry, India has not yet reached the third stage of coronavirus pandemic and there have been no cases of community transmission. So as per the Indian Council of Medical Research, there are four stages of COVID-19 transmission. The four stages can be classified as imported cases, local transmission, community transmission, and the last one is epidemic. So the first stage is when cases of an infection are imported from another country. This means the country which is importing these cases is not the source of infection. In COVID-19 case, all the countries outside of China which started reporting cases of coronavirus reached first stage of the outbreak as soon as they reported their first case. And please note here that if an infection is contained after transmission to only a few countries, it does not become a pandemic. But if it cannot be contained in a short span of time and spreads across the globe like COVID-19 did, it becomes a pandemic. Then comes the second stage. Here, when there are cases of local transmission in a country. This means that the person from whom the infection spread to another person is from the country itself. And the important thing to note here is the trajectory of the virus can be identified from the source to all the infected individuals. This means the infected people in the second stage have come in direct contact with the infected persons from stage 1. Next comes the community transmission, which is the third stage of an outbreak. It is in this stage which becomes hard to track the chain of transmission of the virus. This essentially means that the virus has started circulating within the community and can also infect those individuals who have neither traveled to a country affected by the outbreak nor have come into contact of a person infected by the virus. So it is in this case a lockdown becomes very much necessary. It is because in this stage, any person can spread the virus regardless of their travel history or the people they have come in contact with. So, to prevent India from going into the third stage, which is currently in the second stage, India and many states in India have taken very stringent measures. The country has announced a complete shutdown of all domestic as well as international flights for a period of 10 days. Many states have also placed stringent restrictions on all modes of public transport. Next comes the fourth stage. The fourth stage is when an infection becomes endemic in some countries and keeps resurfacing around the year. India has already reached the fourth stage with respect to some cases. These include malaria and dengue. India has become an endemic to these two cases which keep on recurring every year. But why do we need to classify the spread of a pandemic into four different stages? Well, firstly note that these four stages of an outbreak are uniform across the world. So, it makes countries understand in a simple manner and coordinate among themselves to face such kind of an outbreak. And more importantly, such a categorization makes it easier for other countries to impose measures that they think will benefit, like India imposing travel restrictions on China quite early in the outbreak. By ignoring such indicators, countries like Italy, France and China have passed the second stage and are into the third and fourth stages. Even with the world-class facilities, they are finding it really, really difficult to treat the cases and contain the spread of this virus. You can observe one thing here. In 2019, Italy's healthcare system was regarded by the World Health Organization ranking as the second best in the world after France. Now imagine, countries such as Italy and France, when they are finding it difficult to contain the virus, imagine the plight of India and other developing countries. So it is rightly said that the prevention is better than the cure. Now, as responsible citizens, what we all can do is keep ourselves and our surroundings clean, obey the government guidelines, help the needy, and stay back at homes till the situation is under control.